Hey guys, Andrew here. Welcome back to another episode of No One But You. When we last left off, Yui had taken care of some big ol' nasty bullies for us, and took us to the pond and told her a little bit about her backstory. After that, she told us that we shouldn't be together and left, and that was depressing. So, yeah, that's where we're at now. So, let's get back to the story. The day after Yui took me to the pond, I still couldn't get what happened out of my mind. But it wasn't the bullying, Yui sticking up for me, or even her sad tales which haunted me. Rather, the one thing still on my mind was my attempted confession. I can't believe I tried to confess my feelings to her. Even though Yui cut me off before I could finish, just thinking about it is making my face boil. Along with those fond thoughts, however, was the painful reality of how it all ended. Every time I try to break down the barriers between us, she just builds more. Yui has bottled up all of her emotions inside, and now she's afraid to let them out. Even now, she blames herself for things which simply weren't her fault, and she's afraid that if she lets her guard down, she'll wind up hurting those close to her. Huh. But I won't let things turn out like that. There has to be a way I can fix this. I have to talk to her again. As I began searching for Yui, a familiar voice called out to me.
Oh, look who it is, the wuss who needs to be saved by a girl. I couldn't have said it better myself.
Again already? I guess the fear wore off sooner than I had hoped. Not you again. I don't have time for your bullshit.
Wow, the cat's finally showed his claws. Acting all tough now because you think you were scared of you?
I don't want you to be scared of me. I just want you to leave me alone. Are the two of you really so insecure that you need to show off in front of others? Do you really have nothing better to do in your pathetic, puny lives than annoy other people? How about you grow up a little? You're both 18 years old. You should know better. And now, can you leave me alone? I've got things to do. The girl stared at me blankly, surprised by my unfamiliar attitude and unexpected words. They had been expecting an easy target, but after hearing of Yui's experience with bullies, I had no further tolerance for their crap.
Huh. Let's go, Christy, before he starts crying. Chih, whatever.
The two girls left, still in shock over what had just happened. Okay, maybe I should have hung one of their cats in the tree. After searching the hallways for Yui, I continued looking for her in the classroom and in the courtyard. No matter where I searched, however, I found no trace of her. She's not here either. Did Yui not come to school today? I guess she thought it would be too awkward after what happened yesterday. Either that, or I upset her again. Regardless, I need to talk to her as soon as possible. Okay, we're just gonna skip a day. That's fine. Oh, whoa, hold the phone! Why are we skipping so many days? That's a little much. Still July. Great. 5 days passed, and still Yui was nowhere to be seen in school. I tried calling to her, and I tried visiting her, but no matter what, she eluded me. What about this cat I have to take care of, though? Is she not going to come back for that cat ever again? That's a lot of commitment to lay on somebody. Damn, it looks like Yui didn't come today either. I haven't seen her since the day we sat next to the pond together. She's okay, isn't she? I hope nothing happened to her. I started walking around the hallway aimlessly while thinking. As I reached the window overseeing the courtyard, however, my thoughts suddenly focused on a solitary existence. It's Yui! Yui looked up at me through the window. She noticed my gaze. Yui looked a bit startled. She quickly stood up and started walking away. Yui, wait! Damn it, I have to catch her. I started running down the crowded stairs towards the courtyard. She's gone. I didn't make it in time. If only there weren't so many damn students in the hallway. I looked down at the bench and noticed something. Wait a second, isn't that the lotus scrunchie she's always wearing? It seems like Yui was holding it in her hands. She must have dropped it when she saw me. I have to give it back to her the next time I see her. Whenever that might be. Whenever that might be, I guess. Just keep on pushing the days, you know how it works. Oh god, we're at the last day of the month! Another week passed by without Yui coming to school. I didn't see her once, be it on the street or at the arcade, and failed to hear her voice at all. I again tried calling her and visiting her dorm, but Yui refused to answer, unwilling to come out. I don't know what to do anymore. I don't even know how long I've been staring at this scrunchie. I just can't get Yui out of my mind. She's all I think about. I don't know why, but I feel like there's something missing. It's like I'm forgetting something, something connected to Yui. We both lived in this town when we were younger. Is it possible that... As I thought back to the past, I continued staring at the scrunchie. Gah, my head. It hurts so much. What the heck is going on? Ah!
I wish I didn't have to leave tomorrow. We could have gone here together.
Yeah, that would have been fun.
Huh.
This girl seems really sad. I have to cheer her up. Oh, that reminds me. I went there earlier today. I won this at the claw machine thingy, and I want you to have it.
Eh?
I handed over the Lotus Scrunchie I won. I can't really use this myself, so...
It's so pretty. Can I really have this?
Of course. Think of it as a sign of our friendship.
Friendship?
Sure. We're friends now, aren't we?
Yeah.
Then let's let this be proof of our promise. One day we'll meet again, and we'll go to the arcade together.
I'd love to.
Okay, mission successful. Now then, I suppose I should leave Yui alone for a while and let her think. She must have a lot in her mind with her parents wanting to leave and all. Ah, shoot, I should be heading home now. It was really nice meeting you, Yui. I stood up. Wherever you end up, I hope you have fun.
Thank you.
I started to walk away while waving goodbye. Oh, one more thing, Yui.
Yeah?
The next time we meet, I promise I'll beat your high score.
Heh, I'd love to see you try.
Until we meet again.
Until we meet again.
Yui, huh? What a nice girl. Come to think of it, that would make her the second friend I've ever made. I don't know why, but talking to her felt easy. Yeah, I wasn't shy or scared like I usually am with new people. Huh. I hope I get to see her again. Ah, I called it, guys. I knew I was the boy at the pond. Of course I was. That's how it works in these stories. I remember her. I actually remembered something from my past. Without me realizing it, tears began to stream down my cheeks. I only remembered a small fraction of my past, but it'll do. Now, the only thing I need is Yui. I looked at the scrunchie again. She had this with her the whole time. She didn't forget about me after all these years. She even came back here hoping to see me again. And yet, the person she was looking for was in front of her this whole time. Huh. I held onto the scrunchie tightly. I need to see Yui. Probably right away, right?
That's probably the right answer. I don't know, just in case I'm gonna quick save it, in case I was wrong.
I need to see her now. There's so much we have to talk about. I've left her waiting for too long. There's no way I can wait another day. I quickly fled my house and started running down the street. I reached the dorms in record time, completely out of breath as I arrived. But with my goal in front of me, my focus remained elsewhere. I looked towards Yui's window and watched her quickly close her curtains as she noticed me. Chuh, I'm not going to let you go that easily. Oh my god, that sounds like a predator. Also, how is this window half lit? Is that like a curtain? Also, how is this window like top lit? Because if that's a curtain, then that makes no sense. Anyways, I quickly pulled out my phone and started texting her. I know you're there, Yui. You can't hide from me forever. I really need to talk to you. It's about something important. Huh. Yui didn't reply to my text. Damn it, Yui. Hey, Yui, I know you're in there. Can you stop this and talk to me already? I'm not going to leave until you come out. I shouted from the top of my lungs as students started looking at me from their windows. I'll wait right here until you come out and talk to me. As I stood there, I noticed cold little drops of water started to fall on my face. It's raining. Ah, jeez. Minutes started going by, then hours. I kept standing there without moving, looking at her room. I could see students talking to each other while pointing fingers at me, wondering what I was doing. But I didn't care. The only person I cared about was right in front of me, hiding behind a locked door. And in return for my persistence, Yui finally opened her window.
What the hell is wrong with you? Are you crazy? It's raining like hell outside. Why are you still out there?
Like some rain is gonna stop me. I'll stand here all night if I have to.
Why are you doing this?
I want to talk to you, Yui. I have to.
Huh.
Yui slammed her window, and minutes later, she finally left her room.
Here I am, Hideki. Are you satisfied now?
Yui. Her clothes quickly started getting drenched with water.
What do you want from me, Hideki? Why do you want to talk to a person like me? I'm an awful person. All I do is make the lives of others miserable.
Don't you dare say that. Do you think I talk to you because I feel like I have to? Like it's an obligation? I do it because I want to. I do it because I love you. Yui stood there, stunned. Yes, I said it. I love you, Yui.
Huh. Idiot, you don't really mean that. You're just confused. I'm not a person who deserves love.
Why do you always act like that? Why do you hate yourself so much? My feelings are true. I know they are. I've always liked you, since the second I met you, when we were kids.
What are you talking about?
Yui, it's me. I'm the kid you met that day when you were crying. I was walking home at night when I heard the sound of someone crying. I knew that I had to check it out, and that's when I met you.
Are you serious?
Huh?
You're lying. You're using what I told you to fool me.
I am not. There's something I didn't tell you before. My memories of the first 7 years of my life were erased when I was involved in an accident. There's nothing I remember from my past, not even the accident itself. But I remembered you, Yui. You're the one thing I remembered. It's because I really care about you.
Huh. I'm sorry, Deki, but I can't. I can't believe what you're saying.
Yui turned her back to me.
A lot of people have lied in my face to use me. I can't let that happen again.
Huh. Yui started to slowly walk back to her dorm room. Then, I guess I'll never fulfill my promise. I'll never beat your high score. Yui froze the instant those words left my mouth. She turned back to look at me with an expression of utter shock.
How did you... No, this can't be. Is it really you? How can this be true? You were in front of me all along. You came back to me. You were the first friend I ever had. You helped me go through all the harsh things I had to face. And instead of thanking you, instead of being happy to see you, I treated you so badly. All this time, I was horrible to you.
Yui covered her mouth with both hands and tears mixed with the rain and ran down her soft cheeks.
I can't believe I did this again. I... Huh? Hideki?
How can you even say that? You need to stop blaming yourself for everything that happens around you. You've bottled up all your emotions inside and never let them out. Do you really think I care about how you talked to or treated me? If I didn't enjoy spending time with you, then I would have stopped talking to you. But I didn't, because there was something pulling me towards you. I have always had feelings for you, ever since I first met you next to the pond. And when I met you again, sitting alone on the bench under the tree, I felt the same way. I know I've been stupid recently. There's a lot of things I need to fix. But I can't do this without you. I just can't.
That's codependency. It's not a very healthy relationship, just FYI. Also, it's not July. I'm just never gonna let that go.
Please, Yui, I want to be with you, but I want you to stop pushing me away. I want you to trust me, Yui. We can get through anything together.
Also, why is she wearing the scrunchie if I haven't given her a back yet? I don't understand.
Hideki.
Whoa, that was a really jump cut turn. Yui returned my embrace, hugging me with both arms as she continued to silently weep. We finally met again, Yui. Okay. And... Oh, good! It repeated back to July! It's fucking... Oh, my God! Are you kidding me? No, it's just August! Oh, my God! I can't even... I can't handle how bad this is!
Guys, please. I have one request, developer. Could you please update the time thing? That really drives me nuts, man. It breaks my immersion so much when it literally goes from July to July and then the game says August. Like, come on, man. Come on.
Edie, someone's at the door. Can you get it?
Yes, Mom. I was just about to leave anyway. I walked to the front door and opened it.
Good morning, Hideki.
Yui, what are you doing here?
I thought maybe we could walk to school together.
But the dorms are right next to the school. You came all the way here just to walk with me to school?
Yeah, do you have a problem with that?
Nope, that's actually pretty cute. Ouch! What the hell? Marcy, why did you bite my leg? After Marcy bit me, she jumped into Yui's hands.
Huh, she knew you were making me feel uncomfortable.
This cat sure does love you. And she's not the only one.
Stop that.
Marcy hissed at me. I'm sorry, I couldn't help myself. Okay, let's head out. We still have some time before school to walk around together.
Okay, that sounds great.
Ryui crouched down to put Marcy on the ground, then petted her head.
I'll come back to see you later.
After whispering to Marcy, Ryui stood back up.
Shall we get going?
Yeah, let's. Oh, look at that, laughing. She's pretty cute when she laughs. This year sure was strange, and at times it felt oddly ominous. A lot of things happened, things I never thought I'd be dealing with when I came to this town. I even remembered a part of my past, and although it was small, it was more than enough. Ryui is all I need right now, and I'm glad things turned out the way they did. Oh, well, that's a straight jump cut. All right. Well, hey, guys, we did it. Congratulations. We finally got done with the Ryui route a little bit earlier than I actually expected at the end of the episode, so that's interesting. But in any case, I'm going to go ahead and take the time here to say I guess it would probably be a good idea to start the voting now. I'll probably... She has no nipples. I'll continue the voting probably in the next episode I do. But for now, let's go ahead and say you guys should go ahead and vote on what next girl I'm going to be pursuing, and Ryu. Yeah, Ryu is still an option. So for those of you who don't know, the girls that we have left over are Chinatsu, Shiro, and Ryu are the last three remaining people. So yeah, go ahead, pick a route that I should go on, and then the next episode we will do one last... what was I trying to say? We're gonna do one last vote. There we go. We'll do one last vote, and then we will decide on a route, and that's what the route we'll be going with for the next one, because I'm completing it, guys. I'm gonna 100% this game. It's gonna be a struggle, but I'll 100% it. So, thank you guys for watching. If you'd like to see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me why I'm the worst no-one-but-you player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!